today I just wanted to introduce this video because tomorrow I'm going to get my wisdom teeth done, y'all. Let me see. So I wanted to make sure I got that on film for you guys and also just see the process. I have a volume that I have to take tonight right before I go to bed, and then I have to take it tomorrow morning an hour before the appointment. And they also prescribed me with Tylenol with codeine in it. I'm gonna make sure I get everything on camera if I can. I know that I'm gonna be like bruised up and swollen, but that's why I put this wig on, so I could look semi okay. So this hair is by Wiggins Hair. I will leave the tag down below so you guys can check it out. But I was actually supposed to be doing a video on this hair a while ago, but my phone broke. So today I'm just going to be styling it for you, just straightening it. But I love this hair. This is 28 inches. And I love, it's super soft. It didn't have any like bad smell to it or anything like that. The only shedding that happened was when I was tweezing, so that's normal, but I love, this is not even. Ooh, that's another thing. So that silhouette challenge that's been trending on TikTok and Twitter, I'm about to do it. That's another reason why I got this wig on. Because my mirror is over here, y'all. Alright y'all, so I will come back on later tonight when I have to take my volume so y'all can see that, but I'm doing my hair. Morning guys, it is the next day. I did not film myself taking my volume. I ended up taking it pretty late and then I just knocked out. So so I'm headed to the dentist now. I'm not really nervous actually, but in about 10 minutes I have to take my next volume, so I'll try and record that. But the appointment's not until 10, but I had to be there by 9 so that they can like get everything situated and stuff like that and check me in. But I'm with my mom. Yay. Yeah, she can't stay in, but she gonna walk me in and then chill in the car. Probably
be walking around that building praying.
So I will get back with y'all when I either take my volume or when I get into the seat. Excuse my ash, guys, but so this is the volume. It's a small yellow pill. I took it last night and it put me right to sleep. So I'm about to take this one. It's officially an hour before my appointment. I'm just driving around now because we got there, but she said we didn't need to come in until 10 o'clock, so. Y'all, so I just wanted to come back and let you guys know that I'm home, but my mouth is still like numb, my lips are completely numb,
My face was more swollen earlier today. I have a clip of it, so I will maybe like put it like in the top of the screen so you guys can see. But I'm on chill mode right now. I took the medication like 45 minutes ago, so they said by like an hour and a half it should like fully kick in and I'll start to feel everything. I just wanted to come on and like let you guys know, you know, how I'm feeling and stuff like that. It was a very interesting procedure, I won't lie to you guys. But I'm gonna do like a story time maybe like tomorrow or like in a couple of days when I'm getting 100% better. Right now I'm trying not to like talk too much, open my mouth too much. Well, I've been icing a lot too. I have my ice pack, I have 3 of these. Trying to just ice both sides. I'll probably come back and talk to y'all maybe either later tonight. Show y'all a little glimpse of like what I'm eating and stuff like that. Or if not, tomorrow. Hey guys, I took my medicine once I got home from the appointment, and it ended up like not doing anything, so I've been in a lot of pain. I can't open my mouth. Yeah, it's really uncomfortable. I just wanted to give you guys a quick update. I'm not gonna be talking long, but I have mashed potatoes here. So I can get something in my system, but yeah, this is like max, y'all. It's very uncomfortable. Pain goes from all it right here to right there on both sides. But yeah, so I'm gonna update y'all. I'll probably see y'all tomorrow.
Oh no, 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 no.
Good morning, guys. It's the next day, as you can see. My face is very swollen on this side, but I picked up some mouthwash without alcohol in it. A little bit of work coming. I didn't even breath over there. All you have to do is clean it up and it gives you your mouth. So, I just finished brushing my teeth. What is this? But yeah, guys, I've been drooling a lot. So, like, when I went to sleep yesterday, like, I couldn't sleep in my normal position, which is laying on my stomach, head on the pillow. Definitely couldn't lay on this side. It hurts every time you even, like, push into it. But, when you fall asleep and like you're like sitting up, you naturally just like kind of glide over. Kind of just like turned over halfway on my side and it just rested on my hand. But like I was drooling, like I woke up, it hurts. But I woke up in the middle of the night and it was like hella drool like on my pillow. Yeah, so my face is definitely more swollen than yesterday. I got to brush my teeth and I'm drooling a lot. I wasn't really bleeding yesterday, I don't think. It was probably like a little bit of blood that was just naturally, like I was naturally swallowing, but like I didn't see anything. So, but today I brushed my teeth, even though I didn't even go near it, it was already, blood just coming out as I like tried to rinse my mouth out. So alright, so I had mashed potatoes last night for dinner, which was perfect. That had me actually feeling a lot better because the pills initially didn't work, and so that was kind of like soothing like those areas while I couldn't take the pills yet.
Once I took the pills, I was out like that. I was knocked. 5 minutes in, I was like texting. Couldn't even see the keyboard straight, y'all. Like, it was crazy. I just put my phone down. I'm knocked out.
At this point, yeah, you have minimal swelling. There's no signs of any infection out there.
Okay, yeah.
Pretty much returning back to normal. So I would say, Indy, at this point, like I said, you can continue, just start getting back to normal, eating, brushing, flossing, all that stuff. It should just continue to improve and get better.
Okay.
If you have any problems, if something doesn't feel right, it doesn't seem right, if you get an increase in pain or swelling or anything, or bleeds or anything, then come back and see us. But okay. I think I can let you go now. Okay?
Yay. All right. Thank you. Hey y'all, so it is February 15th, guys. I know it's like mad late since I got my surgery, but I don't know. I guess I just wasn't really in the mood to film my outro and like give you guys like the full details of like what happened during my surgery. So the last thing you guys saw is me at the doctor, at the dentist, getting, you know, a checkup, and give you guys the full story of what happened on the day of my surgery. I told you guys that I had a volume the day before my surgery, like that night, and that volume definitely put me out. I was out like a light, okay? I was out, and then I took another volume 15 minutes before my appointment, and that had me feeling good, y'all. I felt... Y'all know that meme with Mr. Krabs, and he's like, that was me, I promise you. But so yeah, I was feeling good, and yeah, I was chilling. I wasn't nervous at any point. I was so ready to get this done, y'all. So and the thing is, for those who know me, I don't mess with the doctor, I don't mess with the dentist. Like, I really just be scared when I go into those offices. I don't like the smell, none of that. So yeah, so I get in the office, in the seat, and she's like, all right, I'm gonna, you know, put the little clip that they put on your finger to take your heartbeat, so, and my blood pressure and all that. They wrap me up, boom, pow. So I did that, and my heart rate was, you know, it was at 122. And I wasn't really nervous though. Like, I was chilling. I mean, I guess I was like anticipating doing it, but like I still didn't feel nervous. And so she was like, okay, you know, we understand you're a little nervous. We see your heart rate is, you know, a little higher up or whatever. So we're just gonna wait for that to go down. And in my head, like, I'm pretty calm, so I really don't even know what to do. So dentist comes in, and he's like, all right, we're just gonna try and get that down a little bit. So then, mind you guys, for my consultation, he told me that I was gonna take the two volumes, I was gonna have Novocaine, laughing gas, and that was it. That's all he told me. He said he wasn't gonna put the IV on me or anything like that. And he said he was gonna prescribe me with Tylenol or codeine. So I was like, all right, so I'll be all set. So he's like telling me to roll up my sleeve or whatever a little bit so he can put the IV in, and I was like, we didn't talk about doing an IV. You said that I would have the Novocaine and the laughing gas. And he was like, oh, did we? And so they both go over to the computer, and I'm like, why are y'all confused? Like, I'm not. I'm like, I don't like for people to feel like they're confused. I don't like for people to be confused about something that they should be very knowledgeable of, especially when, you know, like, y'all about to do something on me and y'all don't know what's going on. At that point, I was nervous because, like, what are y'all talking about? You know, so heart rate's going up a little bit at this point. I felt like the volume completely, like, went out of my system at that point because now y'all confused. Okay, so it was like, y'all know how, like, when y'all drunk or whatever and, like, say, police come, or like y'all parents or whatever the case may be are around and you feel like you gotta sober up real quick. Literally, that's what I felt like I did. promise y'all. So I'm looking at the system, trying to see what they see. He's like, all right, so if you don't want to do it, you know, that's fine. No, I don't want to do it because that's not what we talked about, period. And he's like, you know, it's, you can do it though, it would be an extra charge. And it's just like, oh, sir, why are we adding extra charges? Like, I already was out there and I paid my $50 because my insurance took care of it. So that's how you know that the IV was never the plan. I'm not about to pay more money, and I feel like that's what you want. So I was like, let me call my mom. So I call my mom because they said that she couldn't come in. I call her and I'm asking her, like, what do you think I should do? Like, you think I'll be good? And so she's like, I don't understand. Like, it's, what do you feel? Like, do you feel comfortable? And I'm like, I don't think I need to do it. You know, it wasn't the plan. That's my whole thing. Once you start switching stuff up, now I feel like something's off. And I wasn't messing with that. So my mom's like, all right, no, don't do it. So I said, all right, fine. So I told him, I was like, no. So he said, all right, no problem. So then he goes and he puts the laughing gas on my nose. And he's like, all right, I just need you to, like, breathe in and out, breathe in and out, so that you can actually inhale, you know, the stuff. So for some reason, he put the laughing gas on and I started breathing in and out. I've never experienced laughing gas before, but I know that when you have laughing gas, it doesn't knock you out. Correct me if I'm wrong, y'all. The laughing gas doesn't knock you out. It just makes you feel like really woozy and stuff like that. I kid y'all not. I was on like my fifth inhale and I felt like I could not breathe. Like literally, I literally could not breathe at all. And so then I felt like my eyes kind of going back. So I'm like, am I supposed to be feeling like this? Am I supposed to be feeling like I'm about to like knock out? Like, this isn't anesthesia, so I'm confused. So at this point, y'all, I'm in a panic. So I look over at the blood pressure and the heart rate monitor or whatever. I promise y'all my heart rate was at 166. And I don't know if you guys know, I saw this on a TikTok, but they talk about like the significance of like your ears ringing and stuff like that, and like communication from like angels and stuff like that. I promise you, my ear started ringing. Like, it was like a high pitched ring, y'all, a high pitched ring. And I was just like, I feel like that's God. God was talking to me, and I need to take this laughing gas mask off my face immediately. So I took it off. My heart rate went down immediately. And they were trying to tell me like, oh no, keep it on, India, keep it on. No, because something's wrong. Heart rate went back down. Come to find out, my mom's right behind me, which made me so happy because I'm glad that she knew that something didn't feel right. So she walked in, the receptionist in the dentist's office, she stood right up and she was like, you need to go in? She's like, yes, I do. She's like, go ahead. And they say nothing else to her. So I was happy that my mom knew something was up and we was on the same page. She came in, she was on the phone with my dad, and he was talking to me, just trying to calm me down and like talk to the dentist and figure out like what's the issue, blah, 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 like all of that. So after all of that, he's like, all right, so you know, this is what we're gonna do. We're gonna turn the laughing gas down and we're gonna just try and, you know, get this out the way. So I was like, okay. So my mom was by me and she was just rubbing my arm. Heart rate was down. It was at like a 122 when I first started, so that was good. Like, I wasn't really, really nervous at that point. And they started getting the teeth out. The first one was mad easy. They popped that out within like seconds. And then they went over to this side. Now this side needed the most work. They had to like slice my gums because both of these were in my jaw. So they were different. They were gonna need like different ways to get it out. And at a point when he got to the very end, I felt like I started feeling like the drill a little bit. Now it didn't hurt, but I knew that it wasn't completely numb. With all of what just happened, I feel like the Novocaine's wearing off now, and you need to stick a couple more needles in my gums. So he gets that one out, stitches it up. And then he gets over to this one, and in the middle of drilling my tooth, I started feeling the drill, y'all. I was just like, I was like pointing, like, you know how like, you can't really say nothing, so you just start making noises or whatever and trying to move your hands as much as you can so that they can know, like, stop. You need to do something else before you continue. So he was just like, are you feeling like it's not that numb anymore, India? Yeah, I am feeling that way, doc, dentist. I am feeling that way. So he gave me a couple more. But he didn't really wait, just went right back to work. So he got that out. And I was done, y'all. So at that point, I was happy. The moment they finished stitching me up, heart rate was back to normal. Like, it was 108. And he was just like, wow. Now that it's over, it's like that, huh? Yeah, because y'all scared the mess out of me. Y'all did. I think I inserted some clips, but if I didn't insert them already, then I'll do it now. But when I got in the car, I didn't feel like nothing was funny because y'all scared the mess out of me. I was genuinely scared. So nothing was funny. I wasn't laughing. I wasn't being all goofy. You know, I was ready to get home and just relax. My mouth, she said to take it out, the gauze out of my mouth, maybe like 15 minutes after I left. She said it doesn't need to stay in that long because you have stitches. So just take it out in 15 minutes and just let it be what it's going to be. You'll taste blood and stuff like that, but it's okay. Ended up keeping it in a little longer because my mom had to stop at Walgreens to get like my prescriptions and stuff like that. So I kept it in, but while I was waiting for her to come out of Walgreens, I started like drooling and blood was coming out. Y'all, I was just like, oh my gosh, like, I need to get home. I was like, I'm ready to take this out and, you know, get comfy. And I was already ready, like, let me just get on the medication ASAP because I don't want to feel no pain. First night was the absolute worst because I took, I don't know what they prescribed me with, if I'm being honest. It was some type of narcotic. Yeah, that shit had me fucked up. It had me done up, but the first one didn't. I took the very first one, y'all, and it didn't do anything. So once the nicotine, oh my gosh, the Novocaine started wearing off, I promise y'all, my entire face from right here all the way down was hurting so bad. Like, I had the biggest attitude ever, and I think that you guys could probably tell in the clip. When I got home and I was like trying to talk, like, I had an attitude, like, I wanted to film because I wanted y'all to see the process and see how my face was looking and see, like, you know, all of that. I was pissed. After that day, after 6 hours passed, I was able to take another one. So my mom's just like, eat some mashed potatoes, have some mashed potatoes. Them shit slept. She did her thing with that and I was feeling better. Mashed potatoes was the way to go the first night. But I had, what happened? I took my second pill and I think I took it at maybe like 8 o'clock. I kid you guys not, in a matter of, my phone's about to die, but I kid you guys not, in the matter of 2 minutes, I was texting and I promise you my keyboard was like extended and all the letters were going in different ways. That's what I was seeing. I was in the middle of texting and at that point I didn't even know what I was texting anymore. I really didn't. I put my phone down, I knocked out, and I couldn't. That's another thing, y'all, I could not go to sleep on my stomach or on my side. I had to sit up and keep my face elevated. So the way I was sitting was the way I knocked out. I was happy that it worked though. So that night I was drooling a lot, like my entire pillow was just like wet. The second day my face was the most swollen. So the first day I had the most pain. The second day my face was swollen as fuck. I felt like I looked like, first off, I look crazy. My face was a box. I was just like, this is not, is this really happening to me right now? I look crazy, bro. At that point, I didn't have to take any more of that other medication. I was just taking Advils and I was icing my face maybe like by the hour. And yeah, but I had penicillin that I had to take every 6 hours until all the pills were gone. And that was pretty much the third day, the pain was still there. It was becoming uncomfortable at a point. I couldn't open my jaw that much more. The way I would eat is like, usually it was always with a spoon, and I would kind of just make a little bit of room and just put the spoon in and kind of like bring it up and just let it like go off of my lip.
What?
Pause. Y'all know what I mean. Fourth day, stitches were starting to come out. The stitches were like dissolving, but I believe the dentist wrapped some of the stitches around like my teeth closest to my wisdom, because just to like kind of hold it in place. But stitches were like just dissolving, but some were just like hanging on and like dangling in my mouth. My gums were already very sensitive, that the stitches rubbing against it was annoying me so much. Basically every other day after fourth to fifth day, and then all the way to my checkup, like I was chilling, like it was okay. My face was definitely not swollen anymore. I believe put salt water, because this one's closed. This top one I believe is closed. This one had the most work because I had to cut my gum on this side and on the top, so there's a little tiny hole. Definitely got a piece of rice stuck in there just yesterday, so I'm still being careful on this side. I'm just not gonna chew on this side because it's gonna be hard for me to kind of like control it. My checkup went good. What I meant to tell y'all, on the third day, I kept thinking about what happened to me at the dentist with my heart rate going up so high. I didn't feel like that was normal. I didn't know why. I couldn't breathe in that moment. I was really scared. And I definitely have like PTSD from that. I'm not even gonna hold y'all. Like, I had anxiety for maybe a week or two afterwards because like I was scared. So I looked it up and I said, what can happen if you have too much laughing gas? So basically an overdose on laughing gas. And they said increased heart rate, difficulty breathing, seizures, some other stuff. But I'm like, so y'all gave me an overdose on laughing gas, and that's why you told me, okay, we're gonna turn it down for you. You tried to OD because I didn't want the IV. That's what happened. You don't even have to tell me, I just know. I looked it up and I saw the symptoms, and I'm like, oh, okay. Like, but y'all was really trying to make me keep that on. That's crazy. How do you not know that? How do you not know the signs of, how do you not know the signs of that? Once I saw that, I'm like, that's really crazy, and I'm glad that I took it off, because who would have known what would have happened if I kept it on? I already don't like going to the dentist, and I was so calm. I trusted them a lot, because a lot of dentists have done some crazy stuff, and I really trusted them. And then you're going, how you not gonna know about overdoses on laughing gas? Hey, come on. You really tried to OD because I didn't want the IV. So, that's the end of my story time, y'all. I'm sorry it took so long. I know it's like a whole different day. I had a wig on my head when I was talking to y'all last. Now my hair is natural. Valentine's Day just passed. I just wanted to finish that off and let y'all know what happened. But yeah, y'all, that's my story. So if y'all getting y'all wisdom teeth taken out, pay attention to that. Make sure these dentists don't play you and they try and change up what they said said that they were gonna do. Don't let them play you. Don't let them try and take your money, all that. Okay, period.